योगः कर्मसु कौशलम्।
Namaskar, welcome to annual refresher program in English language teaching. This is broadly known as Arpit. So welcome to Arpit program. Friends, you know that this is a program of 40 hours. In this 40 hours, we have about 20 hours of video content and about 20 hours of e-content. This e-content includes e-text, discussion, some graphics, exercises, assignments and lot of other things. First of all, I would like to thank you for this enormous response to this Arpit program. The registrations are more than 3,000 and I'm so happy that there is a tremendous response from all over the country. We have lot of discussion in the discussion forum regarding various topics and some friends have suggested me that sir talk about blended learning or a flip learning, which is something very new and we should have some idea about it. So we are trying to include some topics related to blended and flip learning as well. And we are trying to include some other topics as well, which are suggested by the friends. Friends, as you know, global integration and technological advancement have influenced almost every aspect of our life. How education can be exception? Because education is something which is very live. Teachers, we all deal with live audience. We deal with young minds. We deal with people who are really digital natives. Today, we are on the threshold to redefine higher education in this digital era. Because our students, as I just told you, they are digital natives. And they work with almost all the equipments of digitalization. So, digital era is already there. And those who really know how to use these digital things very quickly, very simply, very easily, they are the digital natives. They are born with such technology. They are born with these digital things in the life. So that is why we have to look at education in this digital era from a different perspective. Technology has provided us ample opportunities to expand our access to knowledge and change the entire process of learning. The blending of traditional classrooms with new tools and technologies have paved the way to the student-centered learning. Earlier, the learning was almost teacher-centric. And this student-centered learning has enhanced the employability skills, entrepreneurship qualities in the students. Instead of exerting an unnecessary strain on their nerves and making them mere crammers. It was a time, friends, you all know, I also I'm a witness of it. There is a lot of cramming which happens in the classroom. There is a lot of cramming which happens for the success of the exams. But this student-centered learning, this flip learning, this change in learning system has motivated students in a different way. More importantly, the use of blended and flip learning has replaced the teacher's age-old hegemony by assigning him the new role prominently as facilitator. And as we repeatedly talk about this, we are no more information providers. We are facilitators. We are here to facilitate learning, wherein our role is as a guide and fellow traveler. And we are a fellow traveler in this symbiotic pedagogical adventure where students and we, teachers, travel together. This new teaching technique inspires all of us, the teachers, to engross ourselves in updating our learning and transmitting the same to our students. Thus, teaching learning from the pedagogical hegemony, passive monotonous classroom lectures has acquired a paradigm shift, and the shift is to an activity-based, creative, meaningfully symbiotic endeavor between teachers and the taught. That means our students. We are expanding the domain beyond spaces like now it is expanded outside the classroom. It is expanded outside the hours. It is expanded outside the active hours in the classroom. It happens many a time, friends, that in many such circumstances where we use flip learning or blended learning, teacher even at the 10 o'clock in the night, even 6 o'clock in the morning, or even any time when he is interested, he can float several ideas to the students. And students, even when they are reading late night or even whole night, and if they have some questions in their mind, they can also come out with the questions and they can float it, they can keep them for discussion on different platforms, whichever are used by teachers, and teachers can reply it. I would like to tell you, friends, I have a couple of friends who are practicing this very well. Even I myself practice this many a time when we create some groups, we create some platforms where we give chance to our learners to discuss at any time. That means there is no boundary of time, there is no boundary of space. So it is the need of the time that the teachers should break through the teacher-centered approach and now go towards a personalized learning to transform the nation into knowledge society, lest they have become redundant. So if we won't try to go towards that, as I said, we will be redundant and we will not be current teachers. We will not be updated teachers. We will not be the teachers whom this generation understands. So if we can talk to this generation in their language, in the digital language, in a way which they expect, then really, I guess, we can do miracles. I'm very happy to invite Dr. Neha Haryani to share her expertise on the current trends. She will deal with the concept of blended and flip learning. I'm very happy to invite you, Neha ji, here for the discussion.
Sir. Thank you very much.
So, Dr. Neha Haryani is presently working as an associate professor in English at SB Garda Arts and PK Patel College of Commerce, Navsari. Navsari is situated in Gujarat. She is an accomplished and dedicated academician with over 23 years of professional experience in teaching English language, English literature, and soft skills. She did her BA from SB Garda Arts and PK Patel College of Commerce, Navsari. How you feel, ma'am? Because you have done it from the same college and you are teaching in the same college. So it had been a very great experience, I guess.
Yes, sir, indeed. I really feel blessed.
True, very true. I understand that because when you teach in the same college where you studied, it's a different kind of experience.
Because now I am on the same side where my teachers are there.
So. Very true, very true. And she has completed her master's degree from Veer Narmad South Gujarat University, Surat. She has recently been awarded doctoral degree by Pacific University, Udaipur, Rajasthan. And she worked on, ma'am, can you tell us what exactly your thesis title was or what you worked on?
Yes, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
My title is A Spiritual Journey as Reflected in the Selected Works of Paulo Coelho and Robin Sharma.
Okay, so you have analyzed the works of Paulo Coelho and Robin Sharma, I guess in the light of spirituality. So how exactly you try to look at?
Yes, sir. In a way, a unique work because I have taken two best motivational writers, Paulo Coelho and Robin Sharma. And I have analyzed the work in the light of Joseph Campbell, who is a psychoanalyst. And in a way, my work is interdisciplinary because though I have worked on novels, I have taken psychology, philosophy, religion, and motivation, everything together.
Wow. This reminded me of something. I would like to tell you, friends, that she is a motivational speaker and she is a certified motivational speaker. She has been certified by IAP Career College, USA. As a motivational speaker, she has revolutionized the lives of many through her impenetrable zeal, perseverance, and unique techniques of her motivation. Besides, she is also an image consultant for personal and professional image building. And for that also, she has been certified by International Association of Professions Career College, United States of America. Her unique contribution as a motivational speaker and image consultant accords her a prominent role as an interpreter of culture from the Eastern to the Western and vice versa, thus inspiring her students to understand, appreciate, and interchange both the cultures. That is what she has been doing since 23 years. Dr. Haryani has visited a number of countries on different assignments, and the countries he visited are like United States of America, United Kingdom, Schengen countries, Singapore, Malaysia, Africa, and United Arab Emirates. She was in the quest for her stupendous objectives and achievements, and I guess most of them are fulfilled. That is what we can see from her presentation. She has a wide experience of personal, public, corporate, and educational institutes in image building for both in-depth and broad-based representations. Her experience includes etiquette as corporate communication, personal style skills, presentation skills, dressing etiquettes, wardrobe shopping strategies, interview facing and teaching skills, motivation, stress management, public speaking, soft skills, and total personal makeover. So she has been dealing with the topics which are very much current, which are very much of the use, and she tries to imbibe them in the teaching and learning of the students. She attended pioneering flagship international faculty development program in the United Kingdom, organized in collaboration with the British Deputy High Commission and Government of Gujarat in 2018. On her successful completion of such a program, she, along with her fellow participants, was felicitated by both Mr. Narendra Modi ji, Honorable Prime Minister of India, and Mr. Vijayabhai Rupani ji, Honorable Chief Minister of Gujarat. Dr. Haryani has presented papers in national and international conferences of repute, and she has also published research papers in reputed journals. With this, I would like to invite Dr. Neha to discuss about blended and flipped learning.
Thank you, Dr. Joshi, for inviting me. It's indeed a pleasure to be the part of this wonderful online refresher program in English language teaching. With the rapid rise of technology in the 21st century, the technology vista is widening its horizons in the field of higher education. As technology has become an integral part of our everyday life, it's time for us to cope with it and embrace technology in our teaching methods. At present, it's the urge of the day that we teachers accept, appreciate, and implement new learning methods, such as the blend of the traditional and technical learning. This kind of blended learning will help us to reach and teach the students more effectively and efficiently. Because when teaching blends with technology, it creates a more dynamic and active classroom environment. So what is blended learning? Broadly speaking, it's a combination of online and face-to-face interactions. It bridges the gap between the traditional and digital learning techniques and also helps us to broaden the concept of the confined classroom teaching. It maximizes learning for all the students. To quote Kotal, learning isn't something that has to be confined to the classroom. And so, as I teach blended classes, I think the more I can involve the students in learning and the more context I can involve them in, the more they are going to learn. The idea is to get them to slowly digest the information in different ways and to engage in different activities so that by the time the course comes to an end, they can apply the knowledge they have learned. That's the ultimate goal, to get them to be in a state where they can apply the knowledge. So, the goal of blended learning is to promote student-centered learning by focusing on the learning aspect. And this is only possible when the online and traditional method complement each other. When we shift our focus on learning, we are able to pull the students from the traditional approach of passing examination to the actual acquaintance of knowledge. It also helps them to digest and apply the concept wherever and whenever needed. The process model for blended learning works in three stages: absorb, do, and connect. Absorb is to gain knowledge of the content. Do is to engage in various interactive activities. And connect is to apply that knowledge to the real world situation. Thought leaders have provided a number of blended learning models, but all of them does not go well with college students. But there are a few models which work effectively in higher education and are used at present. One is the face-to-face driver model. Now, this blended learning model is based in the classroom, but a significant amount of classroom time is allocated to online activities. But still, the seat time is the must. And this model works better in diverse classrooms where the students are functioning at various levels of abilities and mastery. Next is the rotation model. This model is used by teachers since years. Here, the students rotate in various modalities. Of course, one of them is the online learning. But here also, first, it is the set schedule with the face-to-face time with the teacher. And from there, the students rotate to other learning stations, such as some group activities or project work. And from there, they go to the online learning station, like the online learning lab in the campus. The best advantage of this model is that here, the teacher is able to provide more assistance to the struggling students based upon their need. Next is the flexible model course. Now, as the name suggests, it offers instructions in multiple modes, online and in person. It is the privilege of the student to choose which class to go, online or in person. The self-blend model. As the other models are course-level models, this self-blend model is a program-level model and is very familiar with college students. Here, the students enroll in the regular courses, go to their colleges and attend the traditional class. But at the same time, they also choose some online course, which is a supplement to their regular course. In a way, it's an additional topping to their regular degree. The online driver. This blended learning course is inverse to the face-to-face class, as most of the instructions and learning is done online, with a few in-person required activities like attending a lab or some classes. The flipped classroom. This model is in reverse to the structure of the traditional classroom of attending lectures and then doing the homework. This is the most popular model of blended learning, and we'll discuss in detail about that in the next segment. The blended MOOC. This model is a form of the flipped classroom where the in-person class activities are a supplement to the massive open online course. Here, the students access the MOOC material mostly from some other institution and instructors outside the class. And then they come to the class for discussions or other relevant activities. This is not mere a static list, but rather a snapshot of the blended learning models that exist in higher education. As blended learning has paved a new way towards the personalized learning. And the key drivers of blended learning are: they improve the ability to personalize instruction. They improve potential for individual progress. It also improves student engagement and motivation, extends the effective reach of teachers, and prepare for online state assessments. It also improves the working conditions. As online education is improving, expanding, and becoming openly available, we, as awakened educators, should remain open and be ready to take initiatives towards the latest teaching techniques, such as the blended learning, because blended learning is a transition from education for life to lifelong learning.
Blended learning is a way of teaching that combines online resources with in-person instruction to create a more personalized learning environment. With blended learning, instructors often make some or all of the content available to the students outside of class time. Taking this to the extreme, students could consume all of the traditional lecture material at home at their own pace, and during class time they could complete work assignments traditionally given as homework during class, as well as other activities like team-based or project-based learning. This describes the flipped classroom model, because it flips what students do at home and in the classroom. Typically, when a teacher creates a lecture, they have to make an educated guess about the knowledge level of their audience, since they have limited information about what each student knows or remembers. If a lecture is too difficult, then most of the students will be lost. If it's too easy, then most of the students will be bored. So teachers typically end up lecturing to the mythical middle of the class, and hoping for the best. By putting their content online, students can move at their own pace. Those who are familiar with the material can go through it quickly, even watching it at an increased speed, while others who aren't as familiar with it can pause to take notes, rewatch it, or call up other resources to help them understand a concept being explained. An additional benefit for all students is that they can choose to engage with the material when they're most alert, which satisfies both the early bird and the night owl. And for those students that have disabilities, they can take the breaks that they need without having to worry about missing out or distracting others. Putting work assignments back in the classroom also has a number of benefits from a learning science perspective. A lot of students describe the frustration of feeling like they understand a concept in class, but then being confused when they go home and try to apply it to an assignment. This is also supported by research. We learn best through active work, not passive listening. Doing work assignments during class time means that teachers are available when students need them the most, when they're trying to apply their knowledge. Another place where students traditionally struggle is with out-of-class group work, because it can be hard to coordinate an in-person meetup as well as make sure those meetings are constructive. Moving group work into the classroom setting makes the logistics straightforward, and it also allows the instructor to keep an eye on group meetings and to help facilitate them if needed. An important aspect of all blended learning environments is that they're not intended to do away with face time in the classroom. Unlike online classes, where all of the material and interactions are online, blended classrooms count on face-to-face interactions between students and teachers. Instead of getting rid of these interactions, blended learning structures are intended to optimize them, moving the teacher from a passive sage on the stage, who delivers didactic lectures to a large audience, to a more active role as a guide on the side, who interacts one-on-one with students to help guide them in ways that might be impractical or impossible with a traditional teaching model. By doing this, blended learning classes move from a teacher-focused learning model to a student-focused learning model. In a traditional classroom, the approach is generally time-based, meaning the whole class moves at the same pace. All students get the same lesson on the same day, and are tested on that material at the same time. And then they all move on to the next topic regardless of their individual exam performance or if they have gaps in their knowledge. Blended classrooms are flexible enough to allow the use of a mastery-based model, which acknowledges that not all students are going to get the material at the same time. Some students might need more time to understand a topic, while at other times those same students will speed ahead. By giving students as much time as they need on a topic, and letting them decide when they're ready to be tested, blended classes can help to ensure that students move forward only when they've shown that they can apply what they've learned with confidence. Blended learning, though, like any teaching approach, brings with it some important challenges. Because this approach depends on technical resources, they have to be affordable, reliable, and easy to use for both the students and the teachers. Oftentimes, there's also a learning curve that has to be navigated, especially for those that have never used technology in the classroom. Another challenge is making sure that the materials are being reliably and independently consumed by the students, and they're coming to class prepared. This can be incentivized by closely tying in-class work assignments to the content that's being delivered online, and can often be tracked with learning platforms. Finally, one of the biggest challenges to blended learning is that it really changes the role of the teacher to that of a coach and puts students in the driver's seat of their own learning, teaching them how to think as well as what to learn. This shift is an important one and requires buy-in from both the teacher and the student to be successful. When it's done right, though, blended learning can lead to a much more enjoyable and effective learning experience for both parties. All right, so as a quick recap, blended learning combines online resources with in-person instruction. And one type of blended learning is the flipped classroom, where students consume their lecture resources at home and spend class time doing in-class activities. This allows the teacher to change from a passive sage on the stage to a more active guide on the side, facilitating a student-focused learning model.